time my mom kicked me out when I was 16. So a little background information. This had all started as soon as my dad left my mom and I. I was like 13 around the time. Well, ever since then, my mom would have different guys in and out of the house all the time. Like, we were lucky if a month went by and she was still with the same dude. Which, I mean, I kind of get it because my dad did leave us for a woman that he had started another family with. But at the same time, it was just a whole mess. Anyway, so she had got with this new guy and we're gonna call him Tyler. And by the way, the dudes that she would date, they would literally live at our house. Anyway, so a week after he moved in, I started getting really close to him, which usually never happens. Usually I would try to keep my distance because I knew how wrong it was of her having all these different guys in the house when I'm only 16. Anyways, every time that my mom would go to work, he would invite me to go see a movie and he would just be really flirty with me. And he was only 6 years older than me. And my mom was 32. You do the math. Anyways, life for part two. Part two about why my mom kicked me out when I was 16. So like I said, the guy was being super flirty with me, inviting me to the movies when my mom wasn't home and all that stuff. Well, then it led to more than just that. By the way, this guy did not have a job, so he was home with me 24/7. And I was doing online school. So we were in the house by ourselves, 12 hours a day, 5 days a week. Anyways, like I said, it led to more and we started doing the nasty and stuff. Ew, just, yeah. Well, the one day after we got done doing the nasty in my mom's room, we had fell asleep. And yes, we did not have clothes on. Well, at 2 a.m, I hear someone pounding on the bedroom door and my mom worked night shifts. So we get up, he hurries up and gets dressed and tells me to hide under the bed. And he opens the door and it's my mom's sister. My sister literally lived in the apartment next door. And she was like, oh yeah, neither of you were answering the phone. So she wanted me to check on you guys. Like, where's Elena? And I'm still under the bed naked. Like for part three. Part three about when my mom kicked me out when I was 16. So like I said, I'm laying under the bed, no clothes on. She asks where I am. And he's like, oh, she should be in her room. So he goes looking for me everywhere with her. And he's like, oh, well, maybe she's outside on the patio. And I don't know why the hell my mom's sister had a key to our apartment anyways. But she's still looking for me in the apartment and she looks under the bed. And at first she's like, oh my god, what did he do to you? And I'm trying to tell her nothing, like I made that decision on my own. So she calls my mom right away. My mom comes home. She's screaming at me and she kicks me out. So I go to my grandma's house and I told my grandma what happened. And my grandma calls her and she's like, it's not her fault that you gave her daddy issues. And I'm like, bruh, what the f-? Child, anyways. So then she goes on Facebook and starts posting about how I'm a whore and a slut and how, like, it isn't her boyfriend's fault at all. So now I live with story time about the girl who beat my ass because she found out I hooked up with her dad. A little background information. I was a junior in high school and I was looking for a job to save up some money for college. So I decided I would try out babysitting. Well, one of the senior girls told me that her parents were looking for a babysitter during the weekdays for her younger sister. And I was like, period, because I needed to make some money. So she gave me her dad's phone number and I texted him the next day. Well, fast forward, I had been babysitting them for a month at this point. Well, during the winter time, this girl's mom had to go to LA for a business trip. And the trip was like 4 days long, Monday through Thursday. Or at least she was supposed to come home Thursday morning. So I was there every day of the week watching their daughter pretty much. Wednesday night, I had to sleep over because their dad was going to a bachelor party. My parents were fine with it because my bus stop was like right outside their house. So I was sleeping on the couch and I heard her dad stumbling at like 3 a.m. He was drunk as hell. And I don't really remember a lot. All I know is that we kissed. Turns out the mom set up nanny cams before I started babysitting. Friday morning, I was just sitting on the bus and their older daughter came up to me and punched me right in my face. Story time about how I was sexually harassed twice while working at Walmart. So a little background information. This all happened last year. So originally I was working in a warehouse, but whenever COVID hit, lost my job, I had to get a new job. So I applied at Walmart in the electronics section because they paid more money, period. And on my second day, I finally went and started working in electronics. So they had asked some of the employees to show me around. So while this one employee was showing me around, he took me to the back where the photos were. Well, whenever I got back there, this employee named Terry said, oh, she's mine. I just laughed and brushed it off because I felt super uncomfortable and awkward. And he knew I was underage because my name tag was yellow. But even after that, he still kept coming up to me, calling me weird names, just being a total creep. Like, he would keep coming up to me and get super close to me to the point where I could literally feel him fucking breathing on my face. So of course I told my manager about it. They said he's done this before, so I was like, why the fuck is he still here? So they moved me to garden. And while I was working in the gardening section, I met this guy named Jordan. Like for a part two. Part two of how I was sexually harassed twice while working at Walmart. Something I forgot to mention in the first part, I reported Terry several times and they still did nothing about it. So like I said, then I met this kid, Jordan. Him and I started getting close, and work actually started to become fun.
Well, finally, after a month, we decided that we were going to go out to lunch during work. So the day that we went out to lunch, he kept telling me that he needed to tell me something.
But he was like beating around the bush the whole time. Like for some reason, he just couldn't get out what he wanted to tell me. But then he kept trying to change the subject like he wasn't the one who brought it up in the first place. I should have took that as a red flag before we went to lunch, but I didn't. So he keeps going on about it in the car, right? And then he's like, I'm not really 20, I'm 25 turning 26. So then for some reason after that, whenever he saw my mood change, this guy has the audacity to start touching my legs, fucking rubbing my inner thigh and shit. I kept telling him to stop. I was like, what the fuck are you doing? So then I told him I'm getting out of the car. And he says, I'm not gonna let you, like, for part three. Part three of how I got sexually harassed twice while working at Walmart. So like I said, he wouldn't let me out of the car, but then we got back to work. And then he had the audacity to keep asking if I was okay when he literally just sexually harassed me in the car. So I went to the bathroom, literally had a whole fucking mental breakdown. I called my mom to come get me because I was not finna stay there. So the next time that I went back to work, I grabbed my stuff and I gave it to one of the workers to go and give to a manager and tell them that I was quitting. Well, one of the managers caught me walking out the back door and she was like, what's wrong? So I immediately broke down. I started telling her what was going on. And then a crowd of people came around us being nosy as fuck, listening to what I was saying. And she was like, you're not quitting. I'm going to take care of this. So she sent me home and she said that she would call me whenever it was taken care of. So 2 days goes past. I'm like, why the fuck hasn't she called? So then I call and I found out that she fired me. So I reported everything to Walmart ethic team, and they just closed my case. They basically didn't do shit about it.
Oh, and Jordan wasn't really a manager. He was a supervisor.
Should I try to take this to court? Story time about my ex-boyfriend. So a little background information. My ex and I have been dating for about 2 years. And throughout those 2 years, he was a dick. He would cheat on me, talk to other girls more than me. But of course, I pretended that everything was perfect in my relationship. I would brag to all these people about how my relationship was so good, blah, 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 and everything else. Because it's embarrassing whenever shit because your relationship is very toxic. Like, listen to this bullshit. The whole 2 years we were dating, I had over 10 girls DM me on Instagram saying that they screwed my boyfriend at his house. I never confronted him about it. I was just one of those girls that cared way too much about what everybody else thought. Okay, now fast forward. And it was a Friday at school, and Thanksgiving break was the following day. And him and I have this whole plan to spend the whole break together, because literally a week before that, he was on vacation in North Carolina for 2 whole weeks. Well, instead of going with him after school, I decided to go home, get an overnight bag, like for part two. Part two about my ex-boyfriend. So like I said, the original plan was for us to go together to his house after school. But I was like, I'm gonna be spending the whole week over there. I should probably pack some clothes and get a shower. So after school, he drove me to my house. And he said that his parents wanted to have dinner together, so he had to go back to his house. And he would pick me up later. So when I got to my house, I got ready and everything, blah, blah, blah. And by this time, it was like 8 o'clock. Well, I kept texting and calling him, asking him where he's at, if he's coming to get me still. Then I realized that none of my text messages were going through. So then I go to text him on Snap. And what do you know, I couldn't find him on there. And then I call him off my mom's phone. He answers the phone and hangs up right away. Well, we were supposed to have a little party at his house too, that all of my friends were going to. So I texted every single one of them. None of them answered the phone. And I remembered that my one friend had shared her location with me before. So I went and looked at her location and where was she at? My boyfriend's house. So while I sat at home crying that whole week, he was throwing parties and cheating on me with my friends. And when we went back to school, he acted like we were never in a relationship. Story time about the girl who beat my ass because she found out I hooked up with her dad. A little background information. I was a junior in high school and I was looking for a job to save up some money for college. So I decided I would try out babysitting. Well, one of the senior girls told me that her parents were looking for a babysitter during the weekdays for her younger sister. And I was like, period, because I needed to make some money. So she gave me her dad's phone number and I texted him the next day. Well, fast forward, I had been babysitting them for a month at this point. Well, during the winter time, this girl's mom had to go to LA for a business trip. And the trip was like 4 days long, Monday through Thursday. Or at least she was supposed to come home Thursday morning. So I was there every day of the week watching their daughter pretty much. Wednesday night I had to sleep over because their dad was going to a bachelor party. My parents were fine with it because my bus stop was like right outside their house. So I was sleeping on the couch and I heard her dad stumbling at like 3 in the morning. He was drunk as hell. And I don't really remember a lot. All I know is that we kissed. Turns out the mom set up nanny cams before I started babysitting. Friday morning I was just sitting on the bus and their older daughter came up to me and punched me right in my face. case.
Story time about how my dad was on the news and now everybody knows my last name.
So a little background information. This all happened whenever I was in sixth grade. This all happened on a Tuesday night. So I had school the next day. Well, my dad had went to work earlier in the day. Well, around 10 o'clock at night, we hadn't heard from my dad all day, which was super weird for him because he was always home around 10 o'clock. And even if he wasn't, he still would have kept in contact with us and let us know where he was at. So at this point, my family and I were really scared and we're thinking that something happened to him. I was calling and texting him. My mom was calling and texting him. My whole family was pretty much trying to get a hold of him. Like, we had called all the hospitals to see if he was there. We called police stations to see if he might have been in jail or if they had his last name in the system. So nobody had heard or seen from him. So we all went to sleep that night hoping that he would show up in the morning. So the next day after I got home from school, my mom came home from work and she had told me about this phone call that she got. Like for part two. Part two of how my dad was on the news and now everybody knows my last name. So like I said, my mom had gotten home from work and she told me about this phone call that she got while she was at work. So apparently one of her coworkers called her and said, "Hey, I think I saw your husband on the news." So after that, she showed me the news article and I couldn't even believe what I was reading. So I guess my dad had been drinking and he went to an auto repair shop and stole a car because I guess the keys were left in the door of the car. And what makes this even worse, the car that he stole had two guns in the trunk. And they weren't two pistols. These were two big ass guns that were fucking loaded. Oh wait, I forgot something. So before this, he had been at the strip club and somehow he ended up in pink lingerie. Guys, I cannot make this shit up. So he was driving around and he decided to park right in the middle of an intersection and it was literally causing a whole fucking scene. There were people with their kids worried as hell. So after that, a few people called the cops, like for part three. Part two about how my dad was on the news and now everybody knows my last name. So like I said, my dad parked in the middle of an intersection and people were calling the cops. So when the police arrived, my dad was half passed out in the car. This happened in like the middle of broad day, like there's traffic everywhere. So when they finally get up to the car, my dad is literally slumped in the driver's seat. There was a bottle of whiskey in the door and it was completely empty. When they went to arrest him, he started resisting. He was screaming a bunch of profanities at them and started kicking them, threatening them with guns, which made the situation worse because my dad had no clue that there were any guns in the back of the car. So that just made the police think that they were his. So they take my dad to jail and he has like 7 charges against him. But we were happy because we knew where he was. Well, the worst part is, so the next day when I went to school, people were coming up to me asking if that was my dad on the news. Some people were even making fun of me because of what he did. And that's really fucking embarrassing for a 12-year-old. But it's okay, Dad, I still love you.